God, this is frustrating.
I feel like we've looked in everything.
Yeah, we have. All right, this is stressing me out. Could you keep up? Contestants on The Amazing Race zipping around the world in season 29 of the hit reality show.
Phil Kogan is the host. Of course, we are thrilled to welcome him here. Hello.
Well, thank you for having me. I feel a little underdressed next to you guys. You're looking so...
Come on, you didn't get the memo?
No, man, you look good. We love having you here, Phil. And congrats on 29 seasons.
29 seasons.
This is huge. What keeps it going?
17 years. I think the fact that the world is a great place to visit and we have awesome locations to get to and always interesting people. And this season, for the first time ever, we've got 22 strangers lined up at the starting line, or we did have at the starting line. We're now underway. And they chose their partner right there at the starting line, and then all of a sudden... Boom, they're racing around the world for $1 million.
So
it's a little different.
This. First impressions obviously matter. They pick their partners.
Right.
Do any of them have regrets?
Oh, yeah.
Because
right.
clearly you're
I mean,
going
some,
you
good
know,
TV.
Some of them have regrets before they even get started because
yeah.
the ones. What we did was we had a little mini challenge at the starting line to give them a chance to see how each other performed under pressure. And so those who did really well, obviously the better you did, the sooner you got to have your pick. So those who didn't do so well, some of them didn't get a pick at all. They got chosen. And sometimes things weren't exactly, I wouldn't say they were like the perfect, it wasn't like the perfect marriage.
Hey, we watch for the drama though, Phil.
Yeah,
yeah.
So that works out.
I would love to know, how would you do as a contestant on The Amazing Race?
I don't think I'd do very well.
No?
Why is that?
Because I just don't really like the idea of being under a microscope for 21 days racing around the world.
Eating bugs.
You know, yeah, being... Look, I get jet lagged and sleep deprived as it is. I don't know if I want to do that and then have somebody like record how I interact with somebody under pressure racing for $1 million.
In the middle of that.
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe in this particular case, I think it's better to watch what other people do rather than be the one that is being watched.
And Chicago even features in this season, right?
Yeah, so we actually end in Chicago. The final leg comes into Chicago and we have some fantastic challenges at the end. And yeah, it's... This city is so beautiful, and when the weather is great, it looks even better. And so we had perfect weather, final three teams racing into Chicago, running around the city, and then ending up with a fantastic
finish. And who were those teams?
Yeah, right.
Well, I could tell you.
You know, I did want to ask them because obviously you're not going to be able to give that away. You can never say it. But in your head, do you ever have like an idea of who could possibly win?
Always.
And how does that play out? What's your track record with
Always
that?
Have an idea. Always have the best intentions. Always lay down a couple of dollars, you know, with the guys to see if we, you know, maybe win a few dollars. Never win.
Never works.
Never do well.
Can't predict this race, that's for sure.
Now, as much as we would love to keep talking about The Amazing Race, you're actually in Chicago working on another project. Tell us about that.
Well, I'm here tonight in Chicago for a one-time only screening of a documentary feature film that I finished. It took me 5 years to make, which is retracing the 1928 Tour de France, which was absolutely brutal. There were 164 people that entered the race that year, and only 40-something finished.
What?
And so I decided to tell the story about the first English-speaking team to ride on the Tour de France by getting an original 1928 Tour de France bike, which weighs twice as much as a modern bike, and racing 3,338 miles, completely circumnavigating France, no gears. And the first documentary feature film shot in with a Sony F55 4K camera. And so tonight at 7 o'clock, we're doing a special screening. Regal have been kind enough to give us let us give 100% of the box office to a charity of our choice. And Bonnie Hunt, who is a Chicagoan and who is a huge supporter of Amazing Race, has a charity, which is the MMRF charity. And so the box office tonight is all going to that charity.
That's fantastic.
And that's a way of us saying thank you to Bonnie for supporting Amazing Race and for supporting me. And I would love as many Amazing Race fans as possible to turn up. And
we hope so.
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock where?
It's going to be
We have the information
theater.
Right here, Phil.
Yeah, City North Stadium 14.
Yes, so if you want to see La Ride, it is tonight at the City North Stadium 14 Theater at 2600 Northwestern Avenue. For ticket information, just go to our website, cbschicago.com. Nobody died. You said 46 finished. I want to make sure nobody died.
Well, people got, you know, some of them got pretty badly injured, but no, nobody died. But it was a race of attrition. It's the most brutal Tour de France ever in Tour de France history.
Wow, this is so interesting. All right, and don't forget, Amazing Race, every Thursday night right here on CBS2. Phil?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Yes, we are tuning
Next
in.
Time I'll dress up a little better. Maybe a,
no.
a suit and a tie.
We love it.
Official
look how good you look, Eddie.
He always looks good. Yeah.